like elocution? What is it that interests y'all should maybe focus a little bit more on that. So why don't you start? I mean, just let's keep it as interactive as possible. I don't want to give a long talk about something that y'all are not able to relate to. So maybe we could keep it as interactive as possible. Y'all could give me some of your experiences about what y'all learned and how y'all liked a certain experience that y'all went for. And then we could see how that would get into y'all understanding the field of law a little bit better. So you would you like to share any of your experiences in public speaking?
Actually, I wasn't really familiar with public speaking at all, but was one time they like some teachers told me to go and participate in something. Or even we had opportunities in during class assemblies or weekly assemblies where we shared. So from there, I really had a good interest in public speaking. Then from there, I participated in thrice in elocutions, won the first prize, participated in debate competitions and state levels, spoke for the police in the Maharashtra. Then, yeah, so I'm really very happy that I anchored many events in my school. So I'm really fond of public speaking because really it was just, I wasn't aware of my own talent.
Right.
I didn't know that I could be so good at it.
Right.
And after that, ever since I really loved doing it.
Wow, that's really nice. Would you like to speak about or tell us a little more about what you like about maybe, you know, thinking of doing something for the government or doing something in that space?
So one of my main interests is politics. I political science is a possible career choice, but I don't know, because all of this interests me, like the recent elections and like what's going on, like for the Rahul Gandhi AT seat and all that interests me a lot. And even in my IB of taking global politics, and like I was one of the classes I love going to because the discussions are extremely interesting. And not only India, everywhere around the world, anything that's going on, I love reading about it.
Okay, that's really nice to hear. Any of y'all would like to share any such experiences that y'all have had in the recent past about, say, even if anyone has any experience in the field of cracking, say, numbers or calculations or something in that field as well? Okay, how many of y'all have thought about maybe thinking of pursuing law as a career? By show of hands. Okay, perfect. We have one person. Engineering. Okay. Something in commerce. Chartered accountancy, if you have heard of. Okay, perfect. And doctors, mass media, if at all. How many of y'all have absolutely no idea about what to do in life and you're still figuring out? Because I was in that position when I was in 8th and 10th. Yeah, so show of hands. Because I chose, as I said, I chose commerce immediately after my 10th standard. And 10th is really too early in your life to know what exactly what you want to do for the rest of your life, right? But I'm taking or choosing a career is a very personal choice. Nobody can be forced to do something. But at this point of time, I think we are at an age where we need to make an informed decision. You need to have weigh a certain pros and cons about what the career could be like, what you could be doing, what are the options that are available. And then maybe think about whether or not you're going to like doing what you're going to be doing for at least a few years after you graduate. So like I said, I decided to pursue commerce, and my first idea was, as in my first career option was to chartered accountancy, because I knew a little bit more about it. I have a chartered accountant in my family, so I sort of knew what the field could look like. I had absolutely no idea about law because I didn't have seniors from high school who were lawyers. I didn't have family, any of my family members who had done law. So that was something that I was very new to. And unfortunately, at that point of time, we didn't have a platform like Talerang where we could get these sort of experiences to understand what you're good at, what you're bad at, and to understand what you could be actually doing, right? My idea was to do chartered accountancy, and then later in my 12th standard, I decided that slowly and gradually I decided that I wanted to do law. Public speaking was something that I was always interested in. I would love going for elocutions, like you just mentioned, something that you just know you like doing or you don't like doing. A lot of people love to write, a lot of people love to analyze things. doing internships at various places as per your choice. Like for example, you could be interning with the Ministry of Law and Justice. You could be interning with a political organization. And the best experience of law school is that because of these various experiences that you get, you would be able to understand what you're good at, what you're bad at. You could be navigating your skills and your interests into what you want to do. And the worst case scenario, if you're not able to figure out or if you don't think law is the best career for you, even after 5 years of law, you could be doing something else as well. Like I know friends who decided to pursue completely different careers after law. So law is generally a field that would open more doors. The field of so let's take two steps back as to what you need to do to get into law school for those of you who think maybe law could be a career for you. So there's an entrance exam called CLAT. It's called Common Law Admission Test. You give that exam immediately after your 12th exam and it has various sections. It has mathematics, logical reasoning, critical reasoning, etc. So after your 12th, after you have given your exam, based on your scores there, you get enrolled into national law schools who have subscribed to the Common Law Admission Test, CLAT exam. And there are about 10 to 12 national law schools in India who have subscribed to that. So you get into national law schools which have a slightly more structured program for 5 years. And if that doesn't really work out too well for you, you could be giving certain other entrance exams that certain specific law schools have. For example, GLC. Now they have an entrance exam called CET, which you need to have given, to get into law school. So you could, even Symbiosis has a separate entrance exam. So you could be giving these exams, and most people start preparing for these exams after 12 or maybe in the 11th, because there are quite a few coaching classes in Bombay. And that really helps, because I decided to do law a little late in my career, in the sense I decided to do it in my 12th standard, and that was a little too late to start preparing for CLAT. So or for those of you who think maybe law could be an option, you could be enrolling yourself for CLAT after your 10th. But nevertheless, like at GLC, I can just share a few experiences that I had, which was not very law specific. It gave me opportunities to do a lot of other things. So for example, I got the opportunity to volunteer with Mr. Milind Deora, if you all have heard of him. He was the then sitting MP of South Bombay. So because the law college was located in South Bombay, I got the opportunity to intern with him and volunteer for the election in 2014. And that really gave me an opportunity to understand a completely new field, to understand how election is done at a ground level, to understand how policies are drafted, to understand how you could be interacting with common people to educate them about elections, educate them about voting, etc. I also got the opportunity to participate in Model United Nations, for some of you who have heard of it. So basically that is like a mock UN. If you all know about United Nations, where you have people representing different countries, and then there are debates around a certain issue. Say for example, if there's a Kashmir issue, so you would be having students representing different countries, and they would be discussing about what they need to do to resolve the issue. So that was a completely different experience, which I hadn't got at high school. I hadn't got at law school at all. And I felt that this is something that you could be doing, a lot. I have some of my seniors who ended up, pursuing law from GLC, and thereafter they decided public policy is something that they really love doing, and they are now working with the United Nations. So there's a major misconception about law, which is that you need to have lawyers in your family to be doing well in the field of law. I don't think that's a prerequisite, although it's helpful because you understand law a little bit more better, but that's certainly not a prerequisite. You need not be only going to the courts to be to be a lawyer. Like a lot of my friends, when I decided to pursue law, the first thing that they told me was I should be able to bail them out of jail if once I become a lawyer. I could be doing that, but that's not necessarily something get insight into how that is. Obviously, you're not going to be majoring in that subject, but you could understand a lot of other subjects a little better, like constitutional law and criminal law and all of that, which is obviously part of the law curriculum. The best thing about law school, I would think, is that it gives you the opportunity to be who you are. So you don't really have to necessarily be doing public speaking if you're not good at it. You could be organizing certain other events as well if you're like doing that. Or you could be doing, maybe something that is not entirely connected to law but you relate to it. You could be working with an NGO for all that matter. You could be working with Teach for India or with any other NGO because that is something that you're really passionate about. So because it's a 5-year course, you get a lot of time to decide and to understand what you like, what you dislike, and thereafter you take a call as to what you want to do. You don't have to be very good at mugging up things, because that's also another misconception that people have. Like when you say you want to do law, they feel like, okay, you should be good at mugging up. Not necessarily true. You don't need to have lawyers in your family, because although they can help you with certain insights into certain things, you don't necessarily need that. And you don't have to be a prodigy child to be a lawyer, honestly. I don't think you need to be a prodigy child to be doing anything in life. You could be doing whatever you want. And if you are really passionate about it and you're hardworking and dedicated, you would be able to achieve what you want to achieve in life. But I would be more than happy to hear questions from you all if you have any specific questions or any sort of questions. I was extremely naive at your age, at 8th standard or 10th standard. If someone told me about law, I would be like thinking, you know, what is it like? I mean, what questions? I would be having tons of questions because I was extremely naive. And it's okay to be that way. It's okay to be confused. It's okay to not know what exactly you want to do. So if you guys have any questions, I would be more than happy to answer your questions.
Yeah, sure. So I am planning to, like, law is an option.